Hello viewers, since I've been doing reviews of Strikers and FC Mobile, which was pretty well received, I thought I might as well make a big video for once. So this is the top 10 best strikers in FC Mobile with thorough explanation and gameplay footage. Skip to this timecode to get straight into number 10. Before we start, I want to set up some rules for this list. The price of these players will be under 30 million, therefore I wouldn't just throw in Ginola and call it a day, alright? Also, it might be great for you free to players out there. Secondly, I will put some strikers in different ranks based on their price. And lastly, I will try to persuade you on why you should buy or rank up these players with gameplay evidence that I've gathered. Now, let's get straight into it. Let's start off with an easy choice. I think Morientes might be the easiest striker to use in this game. This card is what I consider as a starting point for new players. Fernando Morientes, National Heroes, has very well-rounded stats with decent pace and dribbling, 4-5 footing, 4-star skills, and perhaps the best trait is his positioning and strong physique. By just looking at his stats, it is already attractive, and in gameplay, it surely does not lie. If you are new to FC Mobile and does not know which striker to spend your money on, then I suggest starting with Fernando Morientes as your starting point. We started off with an affordable choice to now a very expensive one. As for any Lautaro Martinez I've ever used, he has always been a great striker to play with, and this Champions League version of him is no different. Really good speed, smart positioning, 4-5 footing, 4-star skills, and an 89 physicality that somehow fits into a 5'7 body. But the unique selling point here is Lautaro's dribbling. Combine that with his physicality, then you have a scoring machine with very smooth dribbling, almost like using a cheaper version of Leo Messi. So if you need a definite target man with great dribbling to help you build up your attack, and a striker that actually moves cleverly, then put this guy on your watch list. If you can't afford Champions League Lautaro Martinez, then this is the cheaper alternative. While his physicality isn't as impressive, Dabasuker is still a very smart striker, and usually that is all which is needed for this game's meta, I believe. Very decent pace and great dribbling for a player that is 6'1", 4-star skills, 5'4 footing this time, and an AI which is actually quite clever. And so a basic comparison I can make for this card is that he is a cheaper Morientes with better dribbling. Therefore, it's not surprising to sometimes go head-to-head with this card in rank matches, especially from Legendary 3 to then on. Before you bring out your pitchforks and say that I don't reveal 3-star strikers, well, here's one, alright? And spoiler alert, the next one too. I think I might be the biggest fan of Beto. So big that I actually made a video about him, only for a guy to comment that Isak is better. Listen to me. This is such an underrated card. Insane speed and physicality. 73 dribbling? Which is a fucking lie, by the way. Tell me, does this look like 73 to you? And of course, people will start saying,
Awesome Hand is better, or Open Die is faster.
Oh yeah? Can they do this? This clip is of the base version of Beto. EA even blessed me further by adding a better version of Beto. Despite his ethnicity, at first I didn't know what rule he breaks until I noticed that his skill trait is actually heal flick now, which is perfect for a speedster. Not to mention the fact that his jumping is as good as Noodle Hair Ronaldo, so crossing head with this guy is a fucking cheat code!
Also, this card is cheap as hell, even with higher ranks. So what are you waiting for?
Stop holding your dick and get him now!
Okay, let's be normal again. Okay. Alright, number 6. Marco Van Basten. This is a weirdly underused player in this game. I think people need to believe that just because you have 3-star skills doesn't mean that they're not worth playing. I had quite the blast using Marco Van Basten, and I figured out the best way to use this card is to be very simple. Decent pace, great shooting, awesome dribbling, surprisingly, 4-5 footing, smart positioning, and 68 physicality, what the fuck? Yeah, EA once again lied to us. Marco Van Basten is not 65 physically. Alright, like, does he look like that? I never noticed how effective a 1-star skill is until I used Marco Van Basten. And he's definitely not weaker than Pelé, which is our next guy. Actually, I already made a video reviewing this card and explaining on how to play him effectively, so please go check it if you're interested. But in summary, Pelé Combo Ball is not your common meta striker. This card is kind of a mixture of a striker, a winger, and an attacking midfielder, with the only downside being his physicality and his price. Everything else about this card is just perfect. Anything relating to using his feet, Pelé is a master at it. I hope that doesn't sound weird. But also, thanks to the invention of this bad boy, we don't really have to worry about burning a hole through our wallet just to rank him up. May he rest in peace, and will forever live in the hearts of every football lovers in the world. So yes, y'all. You know we never stop, we never rest, y'all. The black eyed peas will keep the funky fresh, y'all. And we won't stop until we get y'all. Till we get y'all, say yeah. Believe me, I really don't have much to say about this card other than Forlan has always been amazing. I mean, look at those stats. It's just too attractive, man. And they don't lie. If anything, the star of the 2010 World Cup was just made to be a meta. A unique thing about Forlan is that I think this card positioning is so good to the point that it's just clutch sometimes. However, I still think making his footing 5-5 would be more fitting, consider how wacky his left foot actually is in real life. But I guess you gotta nerf him at some point, right? I think this might be the most common of strikers to meet in ranks nowadays. Like, out of every 5 games, you'll probably meet WTF Isaac at least once or twice. Funnily enough, I made a TikTok listing out top 5 strikers under 5 million, which did not include Isaac. And there were comments saying that Isak would have topped the list. And I mean, they're not wrong. WTF Isak is your benchmark of affordable meta strikers. 4-star skills, good speed and dribbling, and the ability to nutmeg using heel-to-heel flicks somehow. And the best of all, both preferred foot. Not to mention the fact that his flair trait is buffed so hard that to the point that this card can do multiple lane changes without slowing down. And this shit is a fucking cheat code, man. I also made a video about Isak, which was poorly received, but it is pretty cool, so go check it out if you're interested. But, ellipsis warning, alright? You guys know it's coming. I just gotta put GOAT somewhere on this list, but it's not gonna be number 1 since he's quite expensive. But that's not really a problem anymore since this guy exists now. I mean, what can I say more about CR7 that everyone else hasn't? Awesome speed, clinical shooting and dribbling, 5-star skills, and a left foot that is somehow still pretty awesome. Like, that left foot is so damn unfair, bro. And despite whatever the hell EA wants you to believe, the GOAT's physicality is definitely higher than Sam Kerr, right? Like, goddamn EA, what makes you downgrade my GOAT so bad? From 90 to 86? Like, come on now. I really hope that he wins the Euros, though. Okay, let's go to some honorable mentions. I know there are a lot of strikers that I suggest you guys should use. First of all, base icon Fernando Torres. Fast, aggressive, great physique, shooting, dribbling, 4-star striker. I'm only putting him here because I don't know. Antonio Di Natale, national heroes. Because this guy is your cheap short king. Champions League, Ciro Immobile, a super cheap poacher. And I know this is a striker list, but Eric Cantona.
if this card was a striker, he'd probably sit at like number 3, number 2. And of course, free Champions League. Finding life along the way,
melodies we haven't played. Alright, if Isak is the affordable one, then Drogba is the better one. Didier Drogba is the benchmark for meta strikers, and second to Isak, he's probably one of the most commonly used striker currently. He has an absolute beast of a physique, with very well-rounded stats, smooth dribbling, and surprisingly 4-star skills. Didier Drogba is a card that is fitting for any playstyles, and that is especially cross and headers. Once you put in a cross for Drogba in free space, he will start jumping like his prime Ronaldo. In my opinion, the Chelsea legend has always had good cards, and this one is no different. And honestly, I think people would probably put other players in this place, like Puskás or Fernando Torres, but to me, the simplicity when it comes to playing Drogba beats both of those choices. The day, these are just my opinions, so I'd like to hear yours. Tell me your favorite top 10 strikers in FC Mobile in the comments. I really like it when people leave comments in my videos. If this video gets 50 likes, then I will probably consider making another one, so please share this video. If you like this video, make sure to leave it a like, subscribe for more contents like this, and thanks for watching and Merry Christmas.